Hello, this is Chetan. Welcome to this video. So in this exercise, what we want to do is to see application load balancer and how to perform the path based routing in application load balancer. So as you know, path based routing is a useful feature of load balancer where you can redirect the backend traffic to different group of EC2 instances based on the URL path. For example, maybe for a particular application, you might have multiple versions like V1 and V2, and then you could have an application URL with a domain name, say myapp.com/V1, that should go to a different set of EC2 instances. And if it's myapp.com/V2, then it should go to the different set of EC2 instances. So this kind of routing is called URL based routing or a path based routing. So AWS application load balancer, which works at layer 7, also supports this feature with which you can manage the routing to different backend EC2 instances. Okay, so for this exercise, what we will be doing is setting up the network like this. We would have an VPC and with internet gateway, and as you know, Elastic load balancer is internet facing load balancer, so we need to have two public subnets in which we will launch our Elastic load balancer across two availability zones. And then we need to have web server as in backend EC2 instances, which should also be in different AZs in different subnets. Ideally, these web servers need not be public facing because ELB is there to get the traffic from the internet. So ideally these instances should be in private subnet, but just for an ease of this exercise, I have been launching this EC2 machines in public subnets only, so that when this EC2 instances boot up, we can execute some user data runtime and just configure them as a web server. Okay, so we'll start with the same thing. We will create VPC. We'll create four subnets, two for ELB and two for EC2 instances, and then we'll launch EC2 instances in each subnet, and then we'll launch Elastic load balancer in two public subnets, and then we'll create a target group and attach these EC2 instances in a target group and attach the target group to Elastic load balancer. Okay, so just let's see that how it works. So let's start with a VPC setup. Okay, so I am there in my VPC console, and let's create a VPC. Let's give it a name, ALB cider block 10.10.0.0.16. As you know, as we create VPC, we always create internet gateway so that we can communicate with the internet. Let's give it some meaningful name, and once gateway is created, let's just attach it to our VPC. Okay, the next thing, you should always look at the diagram. We need to create two public subnets for Elastic load balancer and two public subnets for EC2 machines. Okay, so let's do that. Let's go to the subnets, create a subnet, say ALB public A, and the AZ is first. In Mumbai there are only two AZs, and the CIDR I'll be using 10.10.0.0.24. Similarly, I'll create one more subnet, ALB public B, in the same VPC. This time I will select another AZ, and the block will be 10.10.1.0/24. Okay, the next I will create a route table for public subnets for ELB. I will give name ALB public route table, and as you know, we always have to add a route to go to internet. So 10.0.0/0 and route it through internet gateway. Okay, once that's done, we just have to associate with these two public subnets, and just save it. Okay, so this part is done. We created a VPC and two public subnet for Elastic Load Balancer. The name we have given is ALB instead of ELB. Okay, now let's create other two subnets for EC2, and we'll this time give name EC2 public A, the same VPC, first AZ, and I can take a range as 10.10.11.0/24. Similarly, I'll create one more subnet B, second AZ, and 10.10.12.0/24. We again need to create a route table. We could have used existing route table, but just to maintain the traffic the way we want, it's ideal to have a common route table for the common kind of subnets. So let's create a route table and let's give it a name EC2 public RT. And similarly, let's also add these routes for internet. And the last step is to associate these route tables with these two public subnets which just we created. Okay, so we are almost done with this setup. Just last one thing we need to launch EC2 instances in this public subnet. Now, one thing to remember, we are launching on web server and we will be configuring the web server through EC2 user data. And we want to have path-based routing. That means web server should be able to serve the traffic at particular URL, and that's where the steps will be little different. And I'll just share the user data with you guys. So user data will look like something this, where we install the HTTP web server on first web server. We start the service. We create one directory inside www.html named hi, and then we add an index.html file inside this directory, so that when we hit the URL, something like myapp.com, for example, and /hi, it properly goes to this path. So we need to have this additional step of creating this directory as hi and then creating index.html inside that. Similarly, for another web server, we will have something called py. So it will create an index.html inside that folder. Okay, so let's do this. I'll just copy this user data for first EC2 instance. And now let's go to our EC2 console and launch our first web server. Select E2 micro, and on this page select our VPC and public A as an EC2 public A as my subnet, and I want to give it a public IP so that it can talk to internet and download the HTTP package from the internet. Okay, storage default tags, I can give it a name tag, say web server 1, and I will create a new security group here with the name say web server SG. Okay, and I want SSH from, I don't really need SSH because I'm going to execute everything through user data, so typically I'll just need HTTP. Now, one thing to note here, if you see this diagram, EC2 instances are going to receive traffic only from load balancer. So here optionally you can give source for traffic 80 from load balancers subnets. So these two subnets you should ideally give, and that's what I am going to do. So here I'll say 10.10.00/24, and I will add one more HTTP rule. But this time another subnet of load balancer, that is 1.0.24. Okay, review and launch, and launching with my SSH key. Okay, so we launched first instance in first subnet. Similarly, let's launch another instance. I'm sorry, I just missed using putting the user data. I would have to terminate this instance. Okay, let's again launch the web server, and on this page select public A as in subnet. We want public IP, and below here we have user data. So we will use the user data which I have shared with you guys for the first instance. So let's just put that. Add storage default, add tags, say name tag web server 1, and security group. We might have already existing security group, yes, which I had just created few seconds back. And review and launch. Okay, so first instance I just relaunched, and now let me again launch second web server. This time I'll select EC2 public B with public IP, and again I will put a user data, but a different user data, because this will be serving different path, that is slash by. So I'm just putting that here, and let's just add storage default, add tags, the name tag, say web server 2. Security group, I can use existing one, and I just say launch. Okay, so we have launched two EC2 instances in two different AZs. Now let's go to load balancer and target groups. As you know, load balancer needs a target group. So target group is a logical grouping of EC2 instances. So first let's create a target group. Now in this particular case, as there are two different paths according to which we have to route the traffic to different EC2 instances. So at load balancer level, we need a listener, and then we need to add rules for the listener, and those rules will forward the traffic to different target groups. So one which caters slash high path, and the other which caters slash by path. So we need to create two target groups here. So let's call it ALB high as a target group. It sends traffic to port 80 of backend EC2 instances, and the health check, it must be doing slash high slash index.html, because we have kept index.html file inside a folder called high. Okay, let's create a target group, and let's add target to this, which is web server 1, and just save it. Similarly, let's create one more target group with ALB by in same VPC, and here the path is by index.html. Also, let's add a target here, web server 2, add to register and save. Okay, so both this target group have one instance each, which are unused as a status because we haven't attached this target group to load balancer yet. Now let's go to the last step, which is configuring the load balancer. So let's create application load balancer, give it a name, say ALB. It is an internet facing, yes, and in which AZ we want this load balancer, both the AZs, AZ 1 and 2. So let's select a subnet which is for ALB subnet A and ALB subnet B. Okay, next, security group. So we need to create a new security group for our ALB. So it's ALB SG. And if you see now the security group, we need an port 80 because it is going to serve HTTP traffic, and I want to open it for everyone, maybe IPv4 addresses only. So I just do that, and I'm going to route traffic to different target groups. So we can have a default target group. Hi, as a default target group, and then health checks and everything is automatically configured. Okay, so we created a load balancer and it will take some time. But the important thing is this: here we have the listener which works at port 80. However, we need to configure the rules in this listener. So let's click the rules. Oh, sorry, I went to the target group. Let's go back to our ELB. Go to the listeners, and there you will see view and edit rules. So just click that. And this is the default rule. If there is no particular path, then it will send request to this target group. But what we want is a path-based routing. So let's insert a rule and say if the path matches high star, then forward this traffic to high target group. Save. Let's insert one more rule here. If the path matches slash by star, then forward this to a by target group. Save. Okay, so this is how path-based routing works. You have to insert rules, and in these rules you can write what the path matches to and where you want to forward that traffic to. Okay, so we are done with setting up our listener and the rules, and Elastic Load Balancer will take some time to get provisioned. So let me pause this video for some time. Okay, you can see that a load balancer state is active. That means it's created successfully. And now let's test it. So as you know, Amazon gives a DNS for load balancer, not the IP address. So we need to test using the DNS. So I just copied that DNS. And one thing is we need to test with high and by as a path. So I'm just putting high there, and you see, yeah, it reached the right EC2 backend. So this message is coming from the web server one. And now if you just to say by, okay, this is coming from web server 2. That means our path-based routing is actually working. And if you don't do it, give anything, it would typically just go to a test page. This is because it's going to the web server 1 by default, and in default var www.html directory, there is no index.html, and that's where you see the httpd default page. But ideally, we are trying this, which works perfectly. Okay, so if you have reached up to this point, that means you have successfully configured the path-based routing. You can maybe add more listener like HTTPS listener, assign an HTTP SSL certificates, and also configure similar rule for that particular listener. Okay, so congratulations if you could do up to this thing. Thanks for watching this video.